Here we have a pulse width modulated signal. In fact, as we look at each successive pulse, we can see that it gets wider and wider. If we wanted to analyze some key characteristics of this pulse width modulated signal, such as its duty cycle or carrier frequency, we can use the time signal calculator. First, we need to go to Tools, Add-ins, go down to the time signal calculator, and make sure it's turned on. Okay. Next, we're going to take our pulse width modulated signal and replace it in our input basket. Now, if we go to the time data selection tab, to import our data into the time signal calculator, we need to first confirm that our data source is set to input basket. Once that's done, we can simply hit replace. If you wanted to look at an overview or detailed view of our pulse width modulated signal, we can simply click here under view. And why don't we adjust our y-axis as well? And zoom in a bit more. So there we can see our pulse width modulated signal. Now, if we wanted to calculate a key characteristic like the duty cycle, once our formula box is selected, we can simply click here to insert a function. We could scroll through the entire list to get to the function that we wanted, or we can look at it by categories. We're going to click on tackle category, and we're going to select PWM pulse to duty. Hit OK. First thing we need to do is select our function. We're going to be working on channel 4. That's where our pulse width modulated signal is. And we're going to keep all of the default values except for the cross level. We're going to set that to half a volt. And that's because our signal goes from 0 to 1 volt. We'll hit OK. Now, another function that would be interesting to calculate would be the carrier frequency. So we'll do the same thing. We'll click on the formula box, click here to insert a function, go to the tackle category, and we're going to go PWM pulse to carrier. Select that function, hit OK. It's again CH4, that's the channel number for our pulse width modulated signal. We'll again set the cross level to half a volt. Hit OK. One last thing we'll do before we calculate these functions is change the point ID to something more descriptive to make the data easy to identify. So we'll change this to duty. We say duty cycle, in fact. Next one, change to carrier frequency. Now we hit calculate, and we'll save our data. And we'll use the original name and just append a postscript. Hit OK. Let's look at our results in Navigator. So we have our original PWM signal, as well as the carrier frequency that we calculated, and the duty cycle. Let's look at all three of these in a 1x3 plot. We can grab our carrier frequency and our duty cycle. And what we can see, we have a constant carrier frequency. And we look at the duty cycle, we can see the signal is on less of the time at this end of the pulse width modulated signal. But as time goes up, we can see the signal staying on longer and longer, so the duty cycle is increasing. And that's how we can calculate two key characteristics of pulse width modulated signals using the time signal calculator.